So today we will have a brief introduction of all the Kuhn merchant platform. So as you can see from the left side, this is like a content. We have the projects, AI templates, and whatever, right? So these are the things we are going to introduce today. So each of them, what are their functions? What can you do with them? But before we start, I'd like to show you one of our Smart 720 tour. So from this Smart 720 tour is when you finish a project and what you can share or what you can present to your customers. So let's take a look what we have here. Okay, one sec. It's a little bit slow, I think. Okay, here it is. And I can turn off the auto rotate and also the line. So this is a house with four different rooms and a terrace, so five different areas. And from the bottom left, bottom right here, you can see the five different rooms. Or you can turn on the floor plan. So you can also see the floor plan here, right? And when you click on each of the spot or when you click here for each of the room, you can actually go to a different area. So now we are in the living room, right? And you can take a look at the living room. You can move around, you can zoom in to get a closer look at the sofa, or zoom out to see a whole view, right? Or you can just click on the spot from the floor plan. And now let's go to the living room. So here is the living room that you can see, right? Or wherever you see there is an arrow on the door, you can also click on the arrow to walk to another room. So we are back to the living room again. And let's take a look at the bathroom. Here it is, right? So there are three different ways you can walk through different rooms and you can see the whole view of each of the room. And as a enterprise user, you can also upload your own watermark and your own company logo, your company name on the bottom left side. So later, I will show you from the setting function where you can upload your very own logo and the watermark. Okay, all right. So except these things, I don't know if you guys have noticed there are some little red spots, right? So you see here on the sofa, on the lamp, we have this little red spot. Actually, in the whole project, you are going to use a lot of models, but some of them are the actual products you can sell, but some of them are only the models for decoration, right? So we use this little spot to distinguish them. And whenever you see a red spot, it means that is a product. Click on this little spot here. You can see a main picture of this model and you can see all the information about this model. So later when I show you how to upload a model, that is where you can edit all the information there, right? Then you can even set a price. You can click on this buy button. It will lead you to your online store. So if you have an online store, people can actually see the picture and actually buy the product, okay? All right. And later, when you finish the project, you can share to your customer. So here we have three different ways to share. You can share to the social media, you can copy the link, or you can just show the QR code. They will use their camera to scan and they can directly view the project in their phone, okay? All right, so how about these different settings? Where can you see them and how to do your own customization setting? Let's go back to our merchant platform so you can see. All right, let's use this one, I think. Okay, so we will use this one. And from the left side, the bottom one is the setting. So we can go to the customization. Okay, let's just wait a little bit because I think my Wi-Fi is a little bit slow. So from the setting customization, this is where you can change your very own logo and the watermark. I don't think it's working. Let me open a new page. All right, so here it is. So from here, you see, you can change your company's name. You can design your community authorizes, and you can upload your enterprise logo here, and also for the watermark. So this is where you get the logo and the watermark. And if you want to do some settings for the panorama or the 720 tour we called, so it's right here. And all the function we have seen from the project just now, you can see here, like the floor plan navigator, the product text, the logo, the auto rotate or the line, right? So these ones you can change the setting from here. And if you're a desktop user, you will see if you want to share your project with the three different views, the three different ways, right? You can choose to share two only or to the three of them. And you can also change your loading background. And I see a lot of people use their company or their the designers. You only have the watermark. Make sure you are enterprise user. If you are enterprise user, you will have all of them because this is the for the enterprise account. And for the mobile, there is just one function I'd like to introduce to you guys, the wear function. So if you copy the link or if you scan the QR code with your mobile phone, and you can actually see this wear button. And if you have your own VR glasses, you can connect them together and you can experience walking through the different rooms. Okay, all right. So that is the setting part. And if you are enterprise user, that is the difference here, because for individual, you have only one account, right? But for the enterprise user, you will have more accounts. It depends on which package you buy. But here, I'd like to show you a little bit. So if you are an enterprise user, you will have a main account, which is called admin account. And you can also create some new accounts for your coworkers. Right, so we have the username, email address, password, and you can also set them a role if you want them to be the designer, the manager, head designer, or designer manager, right? So they will have different roles and you can manage these accounts and you can track the data. You can see their projects. So that is the difference between individual user and the enterprise user, right? So here you see, I have a 1, 2, 3. Is my designer, his account is active, right? And what data can I track? So let's move on to the next one, data analytics. Here we have four different categories. So if you are a company with five people using Cool Home accounts, so for all the five people's activities, you can check from here, like how many projects created, how many renderings they make, and you can also see some more in details. So here you can search by day, by week, by month to check how many users are working on the projects, how many projects are created, how many renderings they are making. So here you can see, and we can see the account ranking. So who is using more time on Cool Home account? Who is making more renderings? So you will see who is your hardworking employee, who is the lazy one, right? And last one is about the product data. The product here means all the modules you uploaded to your enterprise catalog, which means the products you can actually sell to the customers, right? So like the existing models, I have uploaded 102 to my enterprise catalog. And the new models are 2, the numbers used in the models. So for 11 projects, I have used the models from my enterprise catalog. So these are all the data you can track. So you will be able to know what is going on in your company, right? Okay, so that is for the account setting parts. And if you guys have questions, you can just leave me a message like Vanessa did, right? So I only see questions from Vanessa. And for the other guys, if you have questions, just leave me a message in the chat box, okay? And then we can move on, right? So next, we have the personal library or the enterprise catalog. These two are actually very similar, but they have huge difference as well. An enterprise, a personal library is only for yourself to use. So all the models, all the textures you uploaded here can only be seen and used by yourself. Nobody else can see it. But if you upload some models or the textures to the enterprise catalog, all the people in your company with whom account can see and can use them. So like I said just now, you are an admin account and you created 5 sub-accounts for your coworkers. So all the 6 people will be able to use all the models here in your enterprise catalog. So that is the only difference. And for the enterprise catalog, you can upload furniture, some appliances, some home decor, some whatever. And you can also upload textures and paving scheme. Okay, so I will show you furniture as an example. So everything you uploaded here, like a sofa, a lamp, a bed, so that requires a 3D model, okay? So let's see, upload models. I will choose one from my computer. Yeah, here it is. How about the armchair? Okay, all right, sorry. I think I missed one. Sorry, cancel. Okay, so let's take a look at this page again. All the models will be uploaded to new product folder, but you can always create your own folders. Like here, I have a new product folder that is by default, and I created table, bed, sofa, lamp, chair, or whatever. So all the folders, you can create it and name by yourself. And then you can upload the model. You can upload 20 models at a time. So if you have 30, 40, you have to upload them in multiple times. And for all the models, the file, each file should not exceed 200 megabytes. So I have seen a lot of inquiries why I cannot upload my models, that because your model is too big. So make sure it's less than 200 megabytes. And we have 6 formats that are allowed to upload here. So it doesn't matter what software you use to create these models, as long as they are Max, RAR, ZIP, FBX, GLB, or SKP. So I think most people use 3D Max or SketchUp to create these models. And so you can upload them here, right? Okay, now let's upload this armchair. Okay, so you see it's uploading. If you have 20, they will all be listed here. And at the same time, you can change the name to give it a name you like, and you can choose a model category. So you see all these things like kitchen bath stuff, household appliances, the lights, the decoration, the doors, the windows. So all the things you can upload to this category. And this one is a furniture, sofa, armchair, right? So choose the correct category and choose a correct location for it. As an armchair is a floor furniture, but if I accidentally choose ceiling light, And later when you use this model in your project, it won't be able to stay on the floor. It will go to the ceiling. So this one is very important. Choose floor furniture. And we just need to wait for it to process. And when we finish, yes, finish, you can click submodel, submit model, check the model. Okay, so it's right here. It's still rendering. But I can show you this one I have already uploaded here. When you finish uploading the model, just click on it. You can still make some further edit. You can still change the name. And for the status, here you can choose if you want to lock the dimensions or not. Because all the models, not only the enterprise, not only in the enterprise catalog, but also in the public library, you can change them into different sizes as you want. But if this one is a real product, maybe you don't have this armchair in a different size, or at least you don't have it in a random size, right? So if you don't want to accidentally change the dimension, you can choose to lock dimension. So later when you use it in the enterprise catalog, you won't be accidentally change the dimension of it, right? And for all the other things are what you have seen when you click on the right spot. So let's go back here. When I click on the spot, so all the information from this page, you are going to edit from here, like the SKU, the product number, the brand, if you want to add a tag or label, and the dimension, material, price, e-commerce link. So all the information you can add it here according to your own situation, right? And when you finish, you can just click save. Then we have successfully uploaded a model. And if you want to upload a texture or some paving scheme, that will be the same. So you just need to get the perfect model or the perfect image so that you can upload them to your enterprise catalog. And later you can use all these ones in your project and they will show a little red spot like this. Okay, so this is about the enterprise catalog and upload models. For the next part, I'm going to play you guys some videos to show you these three, Photo Studio, 3D Viewer Set, and Virtual Showroom. Because these three are for special needs only, it's not like everybody need them. So I will just play some video to give you a general idea to see what it is. For the Photo Studio, is like we can, you don't have to create a room or a floor plan by yourself. We will have different scenes that you can use. And you will just take some pictures of the product you want to present or you want to show to the customers. Okay, so let me see. Let's watch the video together so you will get a general idea about it. Okay, here it is. And then you can select the scene you want as the background. And then we can choose to take a picture or a view. Okay, so they already offer you different angles so that you can choose. Thank you. you can also do some customization, like to change the position or move around the angle of the camera. You can add some other decoration as well, like the floor, the rug, to make it better looking. So here we have the studio finished, and then we can shoot the photos. Okay, so this is the photo studio. It's basically just you choose a furniture first, a piece of furniture first, and then you can choose a scene as a background. And you can also customize the scene and then use the preset angles to shoot the pictures. All right, so this is the photo studio. And next one, let's take a look at what is the 3D viewer. So 3D viewer is also something very good for display. So if you have an online store, and you want to present your sofa in different angles or even to replace them with different parts. And that is a good option. So let's take a look at this one. What is a 3D viewer set? You can choose first to shoot the different parts. Like this is the bucket part and also the leg part. You can give them several different options. This is to adjust the position where you want to put the bucket. Like in the middle, in the center of the this part. And you can adjust the anchor point to make sure they connect perfectly. And you can select different base, different buckets, so that you can make different combinations.
So you can replace the different bucket or the different base. That's why we call it a 3D viewer set. Okay, so this is the 3D viewer set. And next time when you see online stores, they're selling different products, you know how to do that, right? And for the last one is the virtual showroom. So if you want to build a physical showroom, that will take you a lot of time, a lot of money, or a lot of manpower to do that. And it will take you a lot of work to do the different setting, the photographers and everything. But here with the virtual showroom, you don't have to actually get all the preparations. Everything will be built up in the project and you can show them directly the different rooms or the different products you want to present. So it's a little bit similar to the 720 tour I showed you just now, but you will see the difference.
Using Kuom's virtual showroom, give customers the full showroom experience without the overhead and hassle of travel. Easily customize and arrange floor plans to match your products and see your changes made in real time. Kuom virtual showroom doesn't just offer a 24/7 virtual tour for your customers. It's a platform that simultaneously acts as an exhibition hall, merchandiser, sales, and data tracking tool. When your customer clicks a product, Kuom's immersive technology can replicate the equivalent in-store shopping experience by offering them rich product data, including product images, videos, and 360-degree views. Kuom provides a seamless integration with your business's e-commerce site, back-end accounting and inventory to help power your online store. Our goal? Help lower your customers' barriers to purchase and improve your sales. We help you build customer loyalty with easily implementable customer review functionality. What's even more refreshing? Better understand your users' behavior with back-end data and analytics to leverage for your business. Visit kuom.com today. And experience Kuom's virtual showroom for yourself.
Okay, so this is also something you can actually see the products and make a purchase online. Okay, anyway, so these are the three different products, the photo studio, 3D viewer set, and virtual showroom. These three are as our display products so that you can choose to use. Okay, so I think we have only two left. One is a project, one is an AI template. So we will try to explain them together. So for the projects, that is very simple. So this is where you create your own projects, right? And I think it got slow as well. Let's see. Okay, so at the same time, while we're waiting, if you guys have any questions, you can still tap in the chat box. Oh no. Okay, here we go. This page finally came out. So for my project, this is where you can create your very own new project. And what is the first step to get a project? We will need a floor plan. And you can also search just by entering the address or the zip code. You can search for the floor plan in your neighborhood. And you can also import CAD or import an image if you have any existing floor plans. So you can use. I want to show you how to draw. And here we have the wall you can use. That is only one side of the wall, right? And you can also use a room. This one is much easier. So you will directly get a room with a floor and with a roof. You just need to adjust the size of it. So let's change this side 4,000 and the other side a little bit longer, 4,500. Okay, so here is a room and then we can click on the room and make it into a different type, living room. Okay, you can also get it a kitchen, a bedroom, a bathroom or whatever. And then we can put some doors and windows. So maybe a door here. Let's make it 1,000 to the wall. And you can also get a window. How about we make the window a little bit bigger? What about 1,200 and 500 to the wall? Okay, so we have a bigger window. And you can make a duplicate so that for the second window, you don't need to change the length one more time. And also 500 to the side. Okay, so you see, now we have a basic room finish. A room with the windows, with a door, with a floor, and with the ceiling and whatever. So if you want to decorate this, if you want to decorate this room, you can just easily go to our public library or you can go to your enterprise catalog and we can choose a different texture, maybe a wooden floor for this one. So here we have so many different options you can choose. Okay, so whenever you see which one you like, you can just drag and drop it. So you see the whole room will be changed into different floorings. All the other one, the lighter one, I think this one is better, right? So for the walls and the ceiling is the same. Let's got some pink, maybe some blue ones, so you can see the difference. This one for the ceiling. So we have a very beautiful blue ceiling. And some wallpaper. How about this one? So drag and drop, it will be applied to the whole room. And since this is a living room, we can get a sofa. So let's go to the sofa. Okay, maybe this one. Drag and drop, and you can rotate the sofa into the different angle you want. And you can move around the position. And if you think it's too big, you can also change the size from the right side. This is where I said you can change them into any random sizes as you want. So for your own product, if you don't want to change the size mistake, you can lock the dimensions. Okay, so then we can adjust the position. And for the other side, let's put a TV stand. What about this one with the TV? It's too small, right? This one. Can you rotate and then move? So let's take a look at this 3D view. You have a TV stand and a sofa. So if you need a rug or a coffee table, you can just find them, drag and drop. And you can change the position, you can change the size as you wish, right? But if you do the design by all yourself as a professional designer, I know you may have a lot of different ideas, a lot of beautiful ideas for the design, right? But sometimes if you are in your company, let's say you don't have a lot of professional designers, or if you want to get a design in a very short or a very fast way. So here we have another function that can help you. Okay, so we'll leave the room only. How to decorate the room in a very fast way? You can use the AI template.
And here you can choose to decorate the whole house, decorate only one room, or even just make a beautiful ceiling design. So you can go from here. Let's choose a single room. And here you will find hundreds of thousands of free templates in our public library. You just need to select the one you like. And with one click, it will be applied to your room.
Okay, here we go. So in the public library, you will find thousands of free templates you can use. You just need to choose the correct room type or the area size. You can give it a style as well, but you can also take a preview from here. I think the first one looks very good, but you can choose others. So just find the style you like, and then with one click, it will be applied to your room. Okay, here it is. So you see, this is our room. It's very beautiful. It's all fully designed. And if there is anything you don't like, you can just easily delete it. Maybe I don't need two lights. So just select it and delete. And for the other one, maybe I want to move it a little bit in the middle, right? So now it's in the middle. And then for any others, you can replace or you can delete. For example, the sofa, I want to replace with another one from my enterprise catalog. So you can replace it. What about this one? Oh no. So replace. Maybe this one. Okay. So now it's replaced with a new sofa. The good thing about the template is whatever you apply to the whole room, whatever the changes you want to make, you can always get it. So you don't need to worry, it will be directly the same. You can also make any adjustment as you like. Okay, so now we finished this one and let's do some renderings. Today I want to focus on the video part. I think most of you guys knows how to do the renderings for the front view, panorama, or the top view, right? So for the video is a little bit different, but I will quickly show you the front view, panorama. And here you can see the 2D and the 3D view, right? And you can see some settings on the left and also some settings for the camera on the right side. You just need to move around the camera to make it into the correct angle as you wish. And then you can make a renderings. So maybe I want to see the sofa like this, right? Maybe the camera a little bit down. So if I want to make a rendering like this, and you can, so you can just save the current angle here. And then we can make a render. The camera is out of the wall. Okay, like this, right? So we can make a render. Just need to move the camera around to get the correct position or to get to the perfect position as you wish so that you can make a rendering. Maybe let's move the camera a little bit this way too. Okay. Right, like this, a little bit this way, so I can make another rendering, right? So that is for the front view. Panorama is a little bit different because we want to see everywhere inside of the room. So you will place the camera in the middle, and before you make a render, you just need to move the camera around to check in the 3D to see if this is the perfect size, angle as you wish. And then you can adjust the position of the camera. Maybe I want to see more of the sofa. Okay. So I think now it's better. And then we can make a panorama. For the top view, we have only two options. So one is a full wall mode. You will make a render from the ceiling, from the top like this. And also we have the no wall mode. So for the no wall mode, you will make a render from the side and they will hide the wall for you automatically. So this is for the first three, they are pictures. And the last one is a video. And for this video, I have been asked a lot of times how to make a roaming video, how to do that. So let's take a look together. For this one, you can edit your own camera pass. So you will be able to decide how you want your camera to move around. And when we go inside of the two, there are three options. The three lines, the camera will move from left to top, from the left to right. And for the curve lines, it will follow the curve you draw. And vertical, the camera, it will move from the top to the bottom. Okay, so let's draw three lines first. We will try to focus on the sofa. Okay, so it won't be moving like this. Maybe a little bit far away because I cannot see a lot of the sofa. Okay, where is the here clipping? You can move the camera a little bit far away, a little bit closer. Okay, here we go. And now you see, you can see like this, maybe a little bit closer. All right, here it is. So you can decide if you want the pass to be longer, to be shorter, and you can also change the speed. And let's draw a curve lens. So here is the curve. You can make it curve bigger. You can make the curve to the other side. And this is our camera. Okay, so the camera will be moving like this. I think we need clipping as well. So this is how the camera is going to move. The camera will follow the curve. But one thing is that if you want to focus on the sofa, you can also give here, focus the lens. And you can actually move the lens to, this one is difficult to, okay, here. So you can give the focus on the sofa. So now when you move, you see the difference, you see? Okay, and we will also change it 2 times faster. And the last one is the vertical lens. So for the vertical lens, the camera will be show you from the left to the, from the top to the bottom. But I think it gets stuck as well. And I'll show you the, here it is. Okay, so we can choose the starting point where you want it to be start. Maybe from here and the end point to here, okay. Also 2 times faster. And you can draw more lenses as well. More straight, more curved, or more vertical, it doesn't matter. So they will be all listed down there, but I will only take these three as example, and let's have a preview. Okay, so this is the video we made. And once you finish, you can download it. You can add some music, you can add some subtitles as you wish. Okay, I think the three front view are also finished. So let's take a look. Okay, it's a little bit dark. So for this case, you can delete the curtains. So we will have more lights coming from the window. But you can also go here, edit, beautify, and make the whole room a little bit brighter. So let's give it a 10, maybe, or maybe 20. So the whole room will be brighter. But I think the easy way is to delete the curtain. So let me show you. Let's delete the curtains and we will make the renderings one more time. You will see the difference. Okay. All right, so now let's go render. And we will use the same angle. Okay, we'll use the same angle.
Okay, so I think now we're just waiting for the last rendering, and this is everything I'd like to show you guys today. So if you have any more questions, you can leave a message in the chat box. And I think, Selena, do you need to send out the feedback link to the chatting box?
Oh, yes. Please help us fill the feedback form.
So everyone, you can see the link in the chat box. You can click on the link and leave your feedback. And while we are waiting for the last rendering, if you have any questions, just leave me a message. Any questions you want to ask, okay? I think our last rendering is almost done. And we can check the panorama as well. Okay, here is the panorama. You see, you can see everywhere, everything. And because this is a product from my enterprise catalog, it will show you the right spot. You see, that means it's a product. And the last rendering is halfway. Okay, here it is. So you see, I didn't do any other settings. I only delete the curtains so we have more light coming from the window. The whole room will be better. So this time, if you give it some beautify, that will be a lot of better looking. Okay, so you can also get a different filter for it. And if you want to learn more tricks about the lighting customization, you can also keep following our webinar, and we will have more topics that you like, okay? Yes, because the rendering, I only use 1K, so it's not very clear. You can also choose 2K or 4K, but that will take you longer time to render as well. Okay. And once you finish this 1K, you can also upgrade it here. Upgrade the resolution to 2K or 4K. All right. So I think this is all for today. Guys, if you have more questions, you can ask. If you don't have any more questions, thank you for today's webinar, and hope to see you next time.